In the last tutorial, I showed you how to use core WordPress widgets to enhance the functionality of your site. And in this tutorial, I want to show you how to use WordPress plugins to actually reach outside of the WordPress site and install additional software to enhance functionality. We'll get started by returning to the WordPress dashboard and selecting the plugins option from the toolbar. When you first launch a site on the CloudAccess.net platform, there are three plugins already installed. The first is called AskMet, and this is a plugin that helps protect your blog from spamming. It's very useful, but in order to use this plugin, you have to sign up for an AskMet API key. The second plugin that's installed in the site is the Auto Login plugin that we installed when you provision the site from our platform. This allows you to automatically log into the site from the Cloud Control Panel or the CCP. We'll return to the CCP to illustrate what we mean. If you go to the Application tab and click on Login to WordPress, you can get to that back end or the dashboard of the WordPress site through the plugin. The third plugin that's active in the site is called Hello Dolly. As one of the first plugins developed for WordPress by Matt Mullenweg, one of the first developers for WordPress, if you activate this plugin, you'll see a new lyric of the song Hello Dolly appear at the top of the dashboard in this area. Every time you refresh the dashboard, you'll see a new lyric, a new line of Hello Dolly appear in this area. This plugin was developed originally to prove that plugins were possible in WordPress. You can always deactivate a plugin by clicking on the Deactivate link. If you'd like to install a new plugin, click on the Add New button at the top of this page. You'll be directed to a page that lists featured plugins, and you can also link to popular or favorite plugins. There's also a link here to access the WordPress plugin directory. This has a list of all the plugins available for WordPress. You can always access this page independently by going to wordpress.org/plugins. These plugins are arranged by tags, or you can search in the search field by inserting keywords or phrases to find a plugin that has the functionality that you're looking for. You'll find that some plugins are free and that some of them are commercial. You can always manually download and install a plugin, or you can return to the dashboard to use the WordPress installer. We'll search for the Grunion contact form here, a popular and easy to use contact form that we're going to use to create a Contact Us page. Once we locate the plugin in this area, we can read a few details about it, or if we'd like to use the WordPress installer, click on the Install Now button. We'll be asked to verify that we want to install this plugin, and once we click OK, we'll be directed to a page and WordPress will let us know that it's unpacking the package. If we'd like to activate the plugin, click on the Activate Plugin link here. We'll be directed back to the All Plugins page where we can see that the Grunion contact form has been installed and activated in the WordPress site. This plugin allows us to create and add a custom form to a post or page, and we're going to go to our pages and we'll click on the Add New button to add a new page that will feature our form. As we would with any other page, we'll first want to create a title, and we're going to add in the title Contact Us, and that's because this page is going to sit on our main menu and it's going to be the main contact form for our site. Next, we'll click on this small icon here. This is the Grunion contact form, and this is going to take us to the Grunion contact form builder. By default, there are several fields already created in our form, and we can click on this minus button to remove one of these fields, or we can click on the Move link at the top of this field if we'd like to drag and drop it into a new location. The website field doesn't make much sense for my form, so I'll delete it, and I'll click on the Add a New Field link at the bottom here to add a new field. I'll create a new label for this field and I'll title this Playing Ability. And my responses don't have to be a text response or an open-ended response. I have a number of options here and I'm going to select Radio. This will give me a series of responses for my users to check when they're completing the form. The first option will be Beginner, the second option will be Intermediate, and the final option will be Advanced. I can require my users to fill out this field, and when I'm done, I can click on the Save This Field link at the bottom. The field will be added to my form, and I'm going to go ahead and move this above the comments. When I'm done, I'll click on the Add This Form to My Post button, and this is the way the form looks in my page before I publish it. This isn't the way it will look on the front end, and we shouldn't edit this text here. I'll click on the Publish button to publish this page, and it will be live on the front end of the site. If I return to the front end, I can go ahead and refresh this page to take a look at my form. It's added to my main menu, and if I click on Contact Us, I'll be able to view the form. I'm already logged into the WordPress site as the administrator, so my username and email appear here. Remember that this is just one plugin. There are many more in the WordPress community that you can use to enhance the functionality of your site. The next tutorial will show you how to renew your free WordPress site on the CloudAccess.net platform.